Sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin getting. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker ready to go here. This is going to be a ton of fun. Ravens and Bucs, here we go from Tampa. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Here's Brady. Wide open, Gronkowski. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. Fournette, first down, still going. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line. On first down, Brady. Airing this one out for Evans. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Mike Evans, 47 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. They're going to run for it with Jones. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. Looky here, a touchdown, a two-point conversion, and now an onside kick. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think, and maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game. And maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They've got to steal it and try and gain an advantage. And they tried. They just didn't get it done.
throwing on first down. It's Jack. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson looking middle, and it's incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
They'll try and throw for it with Jackson. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Boy, that's some kind of effort. When he caught it, I doubted if he could get there. Knew it was going to be close, but credit him. Really good effort.
How about the rack on that play, the run after catch? But most of the time, we think of it as just being an open field and picking up yardage. Sometimes you have to be real physical in order to gain the yardage you need for a first down.
Inside the 5 to the 4. Dobbins. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. J.K. Dobbins taking it in from 4 yards out. And now the Ravens, they're just a 2-point conversion away from tying this up. Justin Tucker for the extra point. He's got it, so they take just the one here, and that makes it an 8-7 game in the first. Boy, a little panic here early. A first quarter onside kick. And this one travels out of bounds, so unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at their own 44. Fakes the give to Fournette. Now Brady. And incomplete on the deep ball. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
Second and 10. To throw is Brady. In trouble, and he's taken down. On third and long, it's Brady. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Now a pass hauled in downfield. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. First down carry. Busting through contact. Just wasn't a huge hole there for him to operate. Stopped just inside the 35-yard line. Second down, back to Fournette. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
Into the red zone, it's Brady. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Johnson. And the Buccaneers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the five. A tight one. 8-7 our score after one on EA Sports. Now Jones. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Ronald Jones. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. It's a wobbler, and it's intercepted. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. Jackson on first down. And this is caught by Watkins. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. And here he'll get it down to the 7. This defense going to bring out a couple extra DBs here on 3rd and a yard. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. They'll try to run with Dobbins. And he'll take it into the end zone for touchdown. J.K. Dobbins taking it in from a yard out, and the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Tucker with the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And that 14-0 lead to begin the ball game, well, that's gone now. Time to regroup.
I think even up 2 touchdowns, they knew this wasn't going to be a walk in the park. And I think that's why we would see the head coach going up and down the sidelines telling his team, let's stay with it, let's keep going. It's almost like he knew they were going to make their run at him, and they have. As you said, let's see if they can regroup and get going again.
Now Leonard Fournette. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down. Now a second down and 6. Throwing now is Brady. And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 42. They'll try the right side here with Fournette. And he'll wind up picking up about 4, as that is going to bring us to the 2-minute warning. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. Brady going to try and throw on 3rd down. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on 3rd down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected 4th down here.
Check it out,
They'll go for it. It's Brady. Complete. It's Johnson. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. They go back to the ground with Jones. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. Now the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. Second down, here's Fournette, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette taking it in from 4 yards out, and the Bucs have taken the lead. Extra point put through by Succop, and the lead is now 21-14. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. On the return, Devin Duvernay. And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. Meanwhile, Jackson's throw is on target to Duvernay. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. 3 yards remain for second down. Here's Jackson. Sliding out of the pocket. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Rolling to his right.
Like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it here.
Open man is Duvernay.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number 2. Final play of the half here. It's Jackson. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. On the return is Duvernay. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted.
Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. But that one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On play action, now Brady. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there at the moment the ball gets to the receiver, and he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And this one is incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points.
Everything here, we're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Now, three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he's taken down inside the 30. Again, it's Brady fighting to stay upright. Able to get away. They'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Brady gives this one off to Jones, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off, and the Ravens are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. On first and 10, it's Dobbins. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. And what in the world? Not sure if he just heard a whistle there or what, but for some reason he spiked the football. And on 3rd and 8, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. 6 defensive backs. From the gun, Jackson. And this is going to be incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. Now on 4th down here, that pass knocked away and incomplete. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. It's Chuck the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end, Andrews. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Again, Jackson. He'll buy some time right. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down. Here's Jackson to throw. And this will be incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Wide open is Watkins. He's got it. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Dobbins running out of the gun. And room there to work it inside the 25. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. Another run here with Dobbins. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. A shotgun snap and a give to Dobbins. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. On second and 11 now. Jackson. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Lavonte David. And the Buccaneers are going to get the football back as time will run out in this third quarter of play. So it'll be a change of possession on the turnover when we get back. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get, taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
Throw on third down there is incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Brady gonna go on fourth down. Here's Johnson with a reception, and they take this up near the 30 before he's taken down. Brady now on first down. This is caught by Evans. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. To throw, it's Brady. Gonna air it out deep for Gronkowski. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown!